Deceived by appearances. For beauty is found within. When he dismissed her again, the old woman's outward appearance melted away to reveal a beautiful enchantress. The prince begged for forgiveness, but it was too late. For she could see that there was no love in his heart. As punishment, she transformed him into a hideous beast. And placed a powerful spell on the castle and all. Days bled into years. The prince and his servants were forgotten by the world. For the enchantress had erased all memory of them from the minds of the people they loved. But the rose she had offered was truly an enchanted rose. have another, and earn their love in return by the time the last petal fell, the spell would be broken. If not, he would be doomed to remain a beast for all time. As the years passed, he fell into despair and lost all hope. For who could ever learn to love a beast?
Love lives. odd.
Odd? My daughter, odd. Where did you get an idea like that?
Even back in Paris, I knew a girl like you who was so ahead of her time. Different.
People mocked her. Until the day they all found themselves imitating her.
Please, just tell me one more thing about her.
Your mother was fearless. Fearless.
Like the one in the painting.
You ask for that every year.
And every year you bring it.
Then I shall bring you another.
You have my word.
Bye, Papa.
Bye, Bella. Come on, Philippe. You know the way.
See you tomorrow.
Right. Tomorrow, with the road.
Stay safe.
I heard you had trouble with the headmaster. He never liked me either. Can I give you a little advice about the villagers, though? They're never going to trust the kind of change you're trying to bring.
Gaston, we could never make each other happy. I might be a farm girl, but I'm not simple, and I'm never going to marry you, Gaston. I'm sorry. Can you imagine me, the wife of that boorish Ramus? Madame Gaston, can't you just see it? Madame Gaston, his little wife. No, sir, not me. I guarantee it. I won't much rather this provincial life. Madame Gaston, can't you just see it? Madame Gaston, his little wife.
Very hard to see why.
In a dungeon.
Who's got her?
A beast. A huge, horrid, monstrous beast. My daughter's life is in danger. Why do you laugh? Will no one help me?
I'll help Maurice.
Thank you. Will you join me for dinner?
You're taking me as your prisoner, and now you want to have dinner with me? Are you insane?
Uh-oh. He's losing it.
Yeah.
I told you to join me for dinner!
I told you no!
If she doesn't eat with me, then she doesn't eat at all!
Idiot!
You can't talk to us like that, I forbid it.
Am I too late?
Shame, I was really going to tell him off this time.
Mrs. Potts. How nice.
to make your acquaintance. Cheer up, my puppet. Things will turn out in the end. You'll feel a lot better after dinner.
But he said if she doesn't eat with me, then she doesn't eat at all.
Oh!
being so kind to me. Surely you're as trapped here as I am. Don't you ever want to escape?
The Master's not as terrible as he appears.
Maybe I mentioned something about the West Wing.
Never you mind about that. Off to bed with you, Poppy.
Good night.
Nighty night.
Thank you.